Salut à tous, c'est Erwan, on est au dimanche, troisième et dernier jour du Hellfest 2019 et on est avec Alien Weaponry. Guys,
bonjour.
I'm really, really pleased to meet you today. I'll let you introduce yourself for those who don't know you yet.
Yeah, so we're Alien Weaponry. We just played at Hellfest on the main stage. We opened it up. You guys were awesome. So yeah, we're a thrash metal band from New Zealand. We sing in Māori. And yeah, that's pretty much us. We're a three-piece. This is all of us.
I didn't have the chance to see the show because I had trouble this morning. But I saw pictures and video from the Sickle Pit. At this hour in the morning on a Sunday, guys, it was epic.
Yeah, dude. I mean, our second song, we did a Wall of Death. And I mean, to see so many people in a Wall of Death at 10:30 in the morning was amazing, like absolutely awesome.
I think that's probably the best way to cure your hangover is come to an Alien Weaponry show at 10:30 in the morning, because that'll definitely wake you up, people.
Yeah, for sure, it seems to. I tried to be there in July because I heard that you're playing in Paris in July.
Yeah, that's correct.
I tried to be there.
Man, we go to Paris on the 3rd of July, I think, and then after that is Toulouse the 4th, on the 4th. Yeah.
Okay.
And then we got another show that
we can't remember where it is.
Check our Facebook page.
I can check Master Tour.
Yeah.
And you got scratches all over the place too.
Yeah, bro.
Okay. Which one of us can make a little story about the band? When did you create it, and why, and how did it happen that you're here today?
Honestly, we have no idea how we came this far, but basically Henry and Lewis started off the band when they were 8 and 10, I believe. So that was in 2010. They decided to call it Alien Weaponry because they had just seen a movie called District 9, and being 8 and 10 year olds, that sounded pretty brutal and cool. So, I like joined the band about a year and a half later, and we're kind of playing little gigs, and 8 and a half years later, man, we've been all over the world. We've played, the biggest heavy metal festivals in the world, really. So, it's awesome to be here in France. It's our first time at Hellfest, and it's our first time playing in France. And
you guys were amazing.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Honestly, the most insane pit we've ever seen. Like, especially this early in the morning. So, yeah, thank you guys. We don't know how we got here, to be honest. But, we kind of just went with the flow and ended up in France. So, it's nice.
I can see in your eyes that it was a precious moment.
Yes, of course. It was all these moments are very life-changing. And, seeing all those people speaking Māori when half of them can't even speak English. So things like that, it's incredible.
I have a question just to have a perspective of your musical evolution. So I'd like to know if you can remember the first songs or melody that you ever heard, and which one is it?
The first songs and melody that I ever heard. I don't know, man. I guess my really early inspirations came from Metallica, Kiss, and Stevie Ray Vaughan, and probably a bit of Rage Against the Machine. That was when I was like 3 years old, 5 years old. That was what I was listening to. When I was 7, I was listening to Ministry, really all kinds of stuff. Bob Marley, I was listening to that from a really young age. Pink Floyd.
Yeah, I mean, I think, yeah, for us, there was always music playing in the house. Our dad is a very keen musician. He loves music, and yeah, we just grew up listening to music, and I think Lewis covered everything that we listened to. Yeah.
I think my first ever experience with metal was I was playing PlayStation 2 when I was like 8 or something, and I think I was playing SSX, which is like a snowboarding game, and it's the intro song is Run to the Hills by Iron Maiden, and ever since then I've been in love with that song. And I know that was like the first music I ever connected with, and I didn't even know what heavy metal was, and when I finally met these guys, they taught me all about it, and I met all these new bands and stuff, and that was awesome. So yeah, cheer.
And in French we say a gifle. What's the last musical slap you take? The last band you heard, you told yourself, oh, that's good.
Ooh.
So the most recent band.
The most recent one.
Ooh, let me think. For me, I was at Downland Festival about just over a week ago, and I saw a band called Skindred. Now, they are really, 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 really fucking good live. And
yeah, sure.
I just downloaded their most recent album, and I listened to it, man. And they got some interesting. They're like kind of reggae, you know, like no, but they're
hip
hop, metal.
It's real interesting stuff, man. And like it goes off live, and yeah, the mosh pit was insane for them.
Yeah, I mean, for me, I think. I'm trying to think of like the kind of who I've discovered recently. You know, I can't really think of
I've
anything
kind of
at the
rediscovered
moment.
Tool, but
yeah, I mean, we've been rediscovering a lot of bands since we've been back on tour. But,
okay.
I mean, I've seen them a couple times live now, but Gojira, and you know, they've been an inspiration for a long time. But when we caught them at Chicago Open here, back in the US.
Open ear.
Sorry, they were really amazing. So yeah, Gojira is the one for me, I think.
You got one yet?
I honestly can't think of one. Right,
Henry's brain dead.
All right.
So.
I am a goldfish.
Guys, I got to thank you for your time.
Thank you, man.
I'll try to be there in July, and maybe we have the opportunity to continue this interview.
Yeah, for sure, man.
And it will be a real pleasure for me.
Of course.
Thanks a lot.
Merci. Thank you. Bye.